Brandon Ingram has won Most Improved Player Award. I've been on the Brandon Ingram train since he was 18. Me, I believed in him. When they called him a bust, when they said he wasn't the next KD, when they said Kevin Knox was better than him, when they said he should go to China because he only averaged 9 points in his rookie season, I was there. Type of content, make sure you like this video and subscribe. We're on pace of hitting 400 subs. We got 342, I believe, at the time of this video. So subscribe, bro. It's free. Yes, I took a long break from this YouTube. Some of my equipment broke and I couldn't upload, so I got this little thing to transfer my data because my first SD card reader broke, so I couldn't upload. So don't think I was being lazy and neglecting this NBA content. Also, let's shout out to Chadwick Boseman for being the childhood hero that these kids needed. RP, he died at 42, I believe, of colon cancer. Shout out to him. Also, support your local communities, especially the Black communities that need it. That cop that shot Mr. Blake, he's a criminal. No ifs, ands, or buts, I'm not here to argue. I am Black, if you didn't notice. I am Black. And I'm proud of being Black. I do see color. I do see race. Yeah, let's get into some NBA content. Started kind of rocky. 9 points a game in his rookie season. He was thin as he was like, I was more than him. He was like 170 pounds at 6'9". He couldn't shoot at that time like he did in college. He couldn't blow by his defender. He couldn't stay in front of his defender. I think he had going for him was his length. And him being the number two overall pick and getting drafted by LA, people had expectations and he did not meet them. But he was the youngest player in the draft. He was kind of a project, even at the number two overall pick. Just like every European project besides Luka and maybe Dirk. Every European is a project who's getting drafted in the lottery. It's just Brandon Ingram grew up in America and he went to Duke. And so he's supposed to be the next KD because KD came out busting 20 points per game, which is not realistic. So B.I. had a lot of haters second year and even more haters when LeBron came, because LeBron fan base came over and they was talking shit about Brandon Ingram, Lonzo, Kuz, everybody. Then they traded him off and then he got blood clots. Had to remove a whole ass rib. Didn't get a whole offseason of training. And then he came to the Pelicans. And like, I'm a Laker fan, so the Lakers did work with him with his development. Because he was balling at the end of his third year. Then he got injured. And then, you know what I'm saying, blood clots, everything like that. So this wasn't a surprise for me when Brandon Ingram became fantastic. I mean, he kind of was. Most improved player in his fourth year. That's textbook NBA stardom right there. So he came in. New coach, Alvin Gentry, who kind of unlocked his offense. Basically gave him the touches that he needed as a 6'9 guard. And I'm looking, bro, when people look at prospects and draft, they overanalyze shit. Like the momentum shift in their left hips, that shit doesn't matter. Like, look at Brandon Ingram in the simplest way. Is he a 6'9 forward that can dribble? Yes. How many 6'9 forwards that can dribble and handle the pick and roll and handle point guard duties? Ben Simmons, Bron, Paul George, Kawhi, KD, who else? Can Tatum handle point guard duties? 6'9 that can dribble, has pass vision, could shoot in college, has a nice stroke, he's already good mid-range shooter. And he showed glimpses of being a decent three-point shooter. And he was a great slasher because his long reach. So when you have all those things, offensively, Brandon Ingram has no holes. You know what I'm saying? He can create a shot. He can post up. He can spot up. He can cut. He can finish above the rim and below the rim. And he's 6'9 while doing it. He also had a great work ethic. So it was not no surprise that this guy can be a special player, because it's not a lot of people who's built like Brandon Ingram and being a three-level scorer at the same time. So everybody's talking about he's a bust and all that. You don't know basketball. You got caught. Stephen A. Smith talking about shut up. So y'all was really saying he was the most disappointing player when he played for LeBron. Now he's the most improved. It's not because he got away from LeBron, which is part of the fact. It's just because Hooper's hoop. That's basically it. Hooper's hoop, man. So he averaged 24 points a game. almost 7 rebounds and 4 assists while having amazing shooting splits. I mean, a big upgrade, especially that free throw. Went from high 60s to mid 80s in one season with no offseason, bro. No offseason. Went from 33% from three-point range to 39%. He's always been an efficient player, too. And he showed that with the Pelicans as the number one option. That was this close of getting to the playoffs that some guys didn't fuck it up. And then Zion was out for damn near the whole fucking season. But mark my words, Brandon Ingram will be another all-star, especially when the Pelicans beat a playoff team. Come on, bro. You got two all-stars, and if they keep Drew, that's three borderline all-stars. And you got Lonzo with a fourth season. So, all you hating motherfuckers who said Brandon Ingram wasn't this, Brandon Ingram wasn't that, he has arrived. And I've been on the train. When my friend said Kuzma was better, my friend said Jaylen Brown was better, my friend said that this guy, this small forward is better. No. You got to trust the process, bro. Every player is not going to come out the scene balling like Luka, balling like Brown, balling like KD, especially at a wing. So, all you Brandon Ingram haters, enjoy it. We coming back fifth season. And the Pelicans, if y'all don't offer him the max contract, he is going to the Lakers. Redemption season. Mark my words. That'll be all for this video, bro. Make sure you like, subscribe, comment if you want to see. I'm out. Peace.